Good morning. Today's lesson 2.5 is about dilations. Dilations made me think when I was in labor giving birth. I needed to be dilated bigger so that babies could come through. So a dilation is a type of transformation. And a figure. And I will use the same figure that I used yesterday. It's transform. It's made bigger or smaller by a scale factor. Scale factor will determine whether it's bigger or smaller. Now, different than congruent figures that we saw yesterday, the angles remain the same in a dilation, but not the sides, you will see. Let me think now. I'm going to draw a triangle again with points 2 and 1 here. And then points 3 and 3 will be around here. And then 1 with 4 and 1. Maybe I should write the numbers here. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is my triangle. I'm going to say that this is point A, B, and C. Now I'm going to write here A is point 2 and 1. B has the vertex in 3 and 3. And C, a vertex in 4 and 1. Now I want to dilate this triangle. I'm going to dilate it by a scale factor of 2. I'm going to double the size of this triangle. So what we do, and when we have a figure in a coordinate, we multiply each point by the scale factor. In this case, the scale factor in the book says as k will be 2. Okay, so let me draw a bigger coordinate here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And if I multiply this by a scale factor of 2, this becomes 2 times 2, 4. My new x will be 4. And y, which was 1 times 2, it will be 2. The same scale factor here. Multiply by 2 each point. 3 times 2 is 6. 3 times 2 is 6. B will be 6, 6. And C, multiply by 2. 4 times 2 is 8. And 1 point times 2. It will be 2. So these are my new coordinates when I have dilated the triangle by a scale factor of 2. So 4, 2. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Four and two. Here will be my first one. And then 6 and 6, point B, around here, and then 8 and 2, it will be here. This is my new triangle. And these are the points. This is, I'm going to put this because it's dilated, right? It has had suffered a transformation. If you notice, like I said before, the angles remain the same, congruent. This angle will be the same as this angle. This angle will be the same as this angle, and this angle, 1, 2, 3, will be the same as this angle. But the sides do change. The sides get bigger or smaller. That's a dilation. It keeps the shape, but the shape will be bigger or smaller depending on the factor, on the scale factor. A scale factor that is bigger than 1 will be an enlargement. You will have a bigger figure. Enlargement. enlargement. Now you know what I meant. And a scale factor that is less than 1 will be a reduction. How about if a scale factor is equal to 1? If you multiply by 1, there is no dilation. It remains the same, because any number by 1, it will be the same. So this is not a dilation. Now remember, when you want to find the sum of the interior angles in any figure, you only need to follow the formula that we saw yesterday. N minus 2 times 180. So if in your problem today you need to find the sum of the angles, just follow this formula and you will find how many degrees are in total. Remember also the perimeter is the length of the edges. You need to add this plus this plus this in this case to find the perimeter. It's all around perimeter. That's the perimeter. How about if you had two different dilations? They tell you, okay, dilate by 2 and then dilate by 3. Means that this number you now need to dilate it by 3. So you only have to multiply this by 3. 4 times 3, 12. 2 times 3, 6. Right? 6 times 3, 18. 18. And 8 times 3, 24. And 6. A faster way to do this will be to multiply the scale factors. Instead of doing two steps, you say, okay, first I had to dilate by 2 and then by 3. So what you can do is you multiply the scale factor 2 and 3. So the new scale factor can be 6, 2 times 3. See, if you have a scale factor of 6 over here, over the original, 2 times 6 will be 12, and 1 times 6 will be 6. Notice how this new point is the same as if we do it in two steps, 12 and 6. So you can either do steps or you can skip a step by multiplying the two consecutive scale factors by themselves. And then that's the new scale factor, and you use that new scale factor over the original. Area. I believe you will also need area. And to find what happens when you have a dilation of 2 with the area, I can tell you what happened. Let's imagine that we have a square here with size 2 and 2. And then we're going to imagine that we did a scale factor of 2. So 2 times 2 is 4, 2 times 2 is 4. The area of this, 2 times 2, is 4 units square. 4 times 4 is 16 units square. If we did it by a factor of 3, with 2 times 3, 6 and 6, 36 units square. So if you notice each one of these by each factor, this is the original. When you do it by a scale factor of 2, which is here, it's the same as you had taken the original area, which is 4, and you divide it by, since it's 2, the square of the fraction of 2, 1/4. The square of the fraction of the scale factor. So the fraction is 1 over 2. I should have written it here. 1 over 2, but you square it since we are talking about area. And this is equals 1 over 4. If this is a factor of 3, you take the original area and you divide it by the square of 3, which is 9, right? 3 times 9. 1 over 3 square. And if you do it by, oh, we just did it too. So let's say, for instance, this one. You want to find the area by, if you have had a dilation by 2. You check, the area will equals to the original divided by 1/4 is equal to 0.25. You do that in the calculator, and the answer will be 16 units squared. See? 16 units squared. This is the same as this. So, to find the area of a dilation, you divide the original area by the fraction of the square of the scale factor. What happens to the perimeter in a dilation? Let's say the perimeter is all the edges, right? So the perimeter of over here is equal to 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2. Or 2 times 4 is 8 units. The perimeter over here is 4 times 4, 16 units. The perimeter over here is 6 times 4, 24. You can notice that the perimeter is increasing, but what factor do you use to increase it? Over here, you increase by a scale factor of 2. And if you notice, the perimeter increases by a scale factor of 2 because 2 times 8 is equal to 16. And over here, that we have a scale factor of 3, 3 times 8 units times 3, which will give us, oh, give us over here, 8 times 3 is 24. So the perimeter changes in a dilation by the same scale factor that you have used to dilate a figure.